What's up, guys, and what a day today. The ugly is upon us. You're looking at the live video hands-on and unboxing of the Google Pixel 3 XL. Holy moly, let me see my calendar. Oh, we are quite the time away from its official announcement, which is on October the 4th, and it's already unboxed. Wow, that's some another level leak. Okay, so let's do the breakdown of this video. This guy opens the box, he finds all the accessories and paperwork, everything that you would normally expect in a phone's box. We have the charging cable, which is of course Type-C. There's a Type-C to 3.5mm adapter and a pair of headphones as well, which we couldn't find in the previous Pixel version, so that's nice. And then he brings out the Pixel 3 XL, which has a single camera. Yes, it's still a one camera army, and I still think it's going to be the best phone camera this year. The look is very similar to the Pixel 2 XL, nothing majorly changed with the physical design of the phone. But then there is a huge change up front with the freaking display. The mother of all notches, the Deep G, is here from the depths of hell. This notch is the biggest one and has a big chin as well for them front-firing speakers. Last year's model had display issues, and this year's model has, well, some deep issues. Again, with comments like this, Google has still a chance of success. Anyways, it's confirmed that it's having a Qualcomm Snapdragon 845 processor with just 4GB of RAM, and this is not enough. I mean, in 2018, we should have 6GB of RAM with the base model. It should be the standard now. But the Pixel 3 XL could be using the new faster 4GB of RAM from Samsung. We don't know that yet. The display has a resolution of 1440p with 494 ppi, and also it's running the best stock Android 9.0 Pie. And with this Android 9.0 Pie, Google will become a little bit like iOS. Apparently, with Pixel 3 family, you will be forced to use the navigation gestures because they are actually getting rid of the navbar keys once and for all. And personally, I don't mind using the gestures. Some of you might, but whether you like it or not, you'll be gestured. So there you have it, and not much to say. It's in front of you to discuss. My thoughts about this is that if you want to save yourself from the deep notch, then go with the Pixel 3 model, the smaller one. Apparently, that's the one with no notch, and it's just going to have a normal display with bezels, pretty much similar to the Pixel 2 XL, maybe a little bit thicker. And again, the best part is that you won't be seeing the notch on the smaller model. I don't think why they're using notch on the bigger one and not using on the smaller one. I mean, if you want to go with the notch, then go all the way. Like, look at Apple going with the 10 plus and 10, but Google is just bringing the notch to the important XL model, which has the bigger battery. So yes, you will lose on battery size as well if you go with the smaller one, but most of the specs will be same. Anyways, let me know your thoughts. Again, it is a big discussion day about the 3 XL, and yeah, I will catch you guys in the next one. Peace out.